Thank you very much for your invitation and kind introduction. At the beginning, I would like to apologize for my poor English. If there are any problems or questions that I cannot answer, my husband, Carsten Nye, will surely help, and I hope you understand me. The Palace in Aachen is a key building in architectural history, making the transition from antiquity to the Middle Ages in monumental stone building. Aachen Cathedral, which incorporates the former Palace Church of Charlemagne, is the most famous and one of the best preserved Carolingian buildings. Still, there are more remains of the Carolingian Palace complex, for example, the ruins of the King's Hall, and of a corridor which connected the hall with the atrium of the church. This architectural ensemble was modified in Romanic time and rebuilt in the 14th century as a coronation place of the German kings. In the remains of the King's Hall, the town hall of Aachen was erected with an enormous hall for the coronation feast. The palace church was enlarged with huge choir and surrounded chapel. Looking at the imperial aspects of Aachen Palace, I should like to discuss the original idea of the architectural design and its transformation in the medieval period. In Carolingian time, ancient building typology was employed for the design of the palace architecture. Against this background, we have to ask whether Charlemagne also introduced ancient ceremonial manners to his court, together with the design shame. From there, the question would be, what symbolic meaning could have had the representation of these ancient forms? For the high and late medieval period, the following questions have to be answered. How was the former palace transformed into the German coronation place, and was the original symbolism still known, or has it been extended with new ideas? To do my background as an architect, this presentation will be based upon the methods of building research. The palace in Aachen stick out of the other Carolingian palaces because of its strong orientation to the east, the bipolar juxtaposition of church and king's hall, and its reception of ancient building typology. As the palace was meant to follow Charlemagne's Renovatio Imperii Romanorum, the Carolingian master thought antitypes among the ancient palaces of the Roman Empire for the new design. First, a central building as a palace church with an atrium, then a hall with apse, and third, a connecting corridor system. It was surely the palaces in Italy that had significant influenced the shape of Aachen Palace. But we also find traces of the Byzantine ceremonial that, as we know, had influenced the courts in Italy. Since there are very few written records about the ceremony in Aachen, we need to precisely compare the shape of the hall to at least approach a potential answer to this question. Even though the general form very much resembles antique antecessors, the King's Hall in Aachen in detail shows large differences from the ancient examples, for instance, in the position of the entrances. The ancient halls always had the main entrance aligned with the X of the main apsis. A small entrance directly aside the apsis was for the ruler. But in Aachen we do find one or two representative doors in the transverse axis of the hall. And no small entrance for the sovereign next to the apsis. With this entrance situation, the hall rather follow the Frankish tradition, as we can see with the traditional houses at this time. But the King's Hall of Aachen has one significant feature that is different from most of the other ancient and medieval halls. Although obviously new rules exist to the orientation of such halls, the hall in Aachen was exactly orientated to east-west axis, just as sacred buildings. Similar to the design approach for the hall, at first sight, all the palace church was built according to the Byzantine model of short palace church, that is, with a central plan. Yet again, the Byzantine model does not fully work out to antitype. For the Hagia Sophia in Constantinople, we know that the choir was in the center of the church, here in yellow, and that the emperor himself took part in the liturgy. The sanctuary, in red, was separated from the choir. The parish stood in the aisles, here in blue. The gallery was only an upward extension of the for the parish. That means the Byzantine church is one unit, and the emperor stood on the ground floor for most of the time. The palace church in Aachen, however, consists of two different churches with two sanctuaries, the one for St. Mary on the ground floor, and the second one for the Savior on the first floor. Presumably, in this way, the church was divided into a lower church for the collegiate and an upper church for the laity. After all, written sources tell us that Charlemagne was not part of the liturgy. Therefore, he probably took his seat in the upper gallery opposite of the altar. In a first recapitulation, we can say that that for the Aachen Palace, form and typology have been clearly taken over from imperial ancient palace design schemata. Yet the details tell us that neither the ceremonies nor the liturgy were transferred. That means the ancient forms were used by Charlemagne to demonstrate his own claim to power as Frankish king in his Frankish empire. The churches commonly refer to Aachen as Charlemagne's Roma Secunda, and written sources do suggest such interpretation, for instance, to comparison of Aachen with Rome in the Paderborn epic. But we have to bear in mind the dating. Here, shortly before or after Charlemagne's coronation as emperor in Rome in 800, there is hardly evidence for such written interpretation 4 or 6 years earlier, when the building of the palace church in Aachen began. Insofar, the imperial aspects of the church cannot be labeled Roman imperial. Thus, the reception of the antiquity in Aachen must refer to another kind of symbolism. In the following, I should like to offer a hypothesis for discussion which looks into the matter of biblical symbolism. In the Carolingian sources, Aachen was compared to Jerusalem long before Charlemagne's coronation as emperor. The palace church received the title of Solomon's Temple, and Charlemagne was named King David before and King Solomon after the construction of the church. From this we derive a question. Was the centralized architectural shape of the church in Aachen to be interpreted as a new temple of Solomon? The Jewish temple of the Old Testament was a longitudinal and rectangular building. Yet, after its destruction, the virtual image of it became a centralized one. We see this with the vision of Ezekiel and finally with the Jerusalem Association of St. John's Apocalypse. Consequently, the ideas of the Old Temple, the New Temple, and the Heavenly Jerusalem fuse into one new concept. This new concept of Solomon's Temple was used for the first time by the Emperor Constantine the Great for the Church of the Holy Sepulchre in Jerusalem. According to its ordination ceremony, it represented the new temple of the new covenant between God and man, which replaced the old covenant that was destroyed with the destruction of the old Jewish temple. Although Charlemagne used the symbolism of the Holy Sepulchre even for his public relation, the back side of the coin, which was mined after his imperial coronation, shows a temple-like building with the inscription Christiana Religio. The illustration of the building corresponds with the common early medieval age of the Holy Sepulchre. The same text was used by Einhard as a reason why Charlemagne had founded the church in Aachen. Moreover, the church was accommodate a college that Charlemagne endowed to permanently pray for the salvation of the kingdom. To this end, he has also gave permanent relics in this care, which were presents from the Patriarch of Jerusalem. In this way, Aachen became the center of the Carolingian Empire, while Jerusalem was the center of the Christian world. Now the question arises whether the entire palace followed the Jerusalem concept, especially with respect to the employment of terms as Palace of David or Sacrum Palatium. The parallel position of the King's Hall and the Palace Church is easily visible in Aachen. Moreover, they also have been described as Basilica Humana and Basilica Divina. We have seen previously that it was not customary to orientate King's Hall to a fixed direction, but in Aachen the orientation to an east-west axis was enforced with much energy against the topography and all the original Roman urban structure. These are the roads. Even though also the archaeological research on the Temple Mount in Jerusalem today proves an architectural analogy to Aachen, it is after all the significance in the script that must have been a severe impression onto Charlemagne and his court to produce the parallelity. In the Bible, both palace and temple were described as similar sign of a powerful and God-fearing rule. Consequently, it is this employment of the Jerusalem idea together with the shape of an ancient palace that eventually led to an original concept by the Franks. Because of this intriguing amalgamation of ancient design with biblical symbolism, it became fairly easy after Charlemagne's coronation as Roman emperor to add a Roman imperial notion to his government as well as to his palace, the Roma Secunda idea. The Jerusalem and Rome concept for Aachen survived through the whole Middle Ages in political terms. Aachen remained the central place of the kingdom and was designed as sedes or caput regni, although after Louis the Pious, the palace was never again residence for a German ruler and slowly fell into disrepair. However, the Catholic College upheld the importance, especially with respect to the coronation that since Otto I took place in the palace church. The German kings were crowned in Aachen from 936 to 1531. To do this, they continued the old interpretation of the palace and placed themselves in the tradition of Charlemagne. The symbolism of Jerusalem and Rome became obvious also in the medieval art objects in the church. From the Ottonian period, for instance, dates a pin cone, which was most likely modeled after the pina in the atrium of St. Peter in Rome. The statue of an ancient bear was interpreted as Roman wolf. Both stood in the vestibule of the church and were shown to the future kings as imperial manifestation and obligation shortly after they entered the limits of Aachen. Friedrich Barbarossa donated a chandelier in the shape of the city wall of Jerusalem and had it installed under the cupola of the palace church. It's still there. Under it, the candidate had to kneel down to pray after he had entered the church the first time. Still unsolved mystery, we have heard, is the so-called throne of Charlemagne that is situated on the upper gallery of the church. After their coronation at the altar of St. Mary on the ground floor, the German kings were enthroned on this structure. This Sedes Regni, the throne, became the main symbol of Aachen. In art history, it is also interpreted as an image of the throne of King Solomon. However, it is not known when this throne was actually erected or put in this place. Its age could not yet be determined neither by written sources nor studies on the throne itself. Theories include an erection by Charlemagne himself, Otto I or Otto III. An indication for such a late erection could be the modification of the bay in which the throne stands today. This was carried out while the church was newly painted in the Ottonian period. The vault was raised and the rear wall was replaced by an opening with columns. The vault and here the wall behind. In doing so, a transverse axis was introduced to the central structure of the church to emphasize the throne opposite the altar for the Savior, on which Charlemagne crowned his son Louis, 813, to an emperor. While still the probability that the throne is actually Carolingian lives with only 33%, this late Ottonian orchestration produced a strong and lasting symbol for the coronation at the Sedes Aachen. Everyone in the Middle Ages believed that the throne belongs to Charlemagne, and even today, there are generally more supporters of this idea than opponents. Although in Ottonian times, the king's hall had to be repaired. It was probably already very strongly affected by the Norman storm in 1881-1882. It was meant to be used for the great banquet after the coronation that was itself an important part of the whole ceremony. The importance of the original Carolingian concept of the Sedes Aachen, however, was so great that this throne apse was built, although at this time no more halls with apses were built in the German Empire. However, the modification with the heaviest impact into the former palace buildings were carried out in the 14th century and shaped the ensemble until today. Again, the hall was in a very poor condition because no one cared for it between the individual coronation ceremonies. Because of this, the King's Hall was given to the city of Aachen for its own hall, for its town hall, under the reign of Louis IV. He strengthened the German cities while being in opposition to the Pope. The only condition for this present was that the city had to include a large banquet hall for the future coronations. Thus, over the rooms for the administration on the ground floor, a new large hall, so-called coronation hall, was erected, allowing for a strict table setting that reflected the hierarchical order of the empire. On the new main facade of the town hall, which was now orientated to the new marketplace in the north, all kings crowned in Aachen were represented as statues. In this way, already during the ceremony, the kings were able to present themselves in the midst of their predecessors from Charlemagne onwards. Consequently, the building was referred to not only as Aachen Town Hall, but also as palace, as palatium. Charles IV's opponent to Louis IV again supported the church and in Aachen especially the collegiate that had been losing power in relation to the city. Thus, he introduced that the pilgrimage to the relics in Aachen should take place in a regular cycle of 7 years, and he also promoted the religious cult of Charlemagne, who had been made a saint already in 1165, unfortunately only by an antipope. A substantial number of reliquaries date from this time. Most notable is this reliquary for the skull of Charlemagne that shows the facial feature of Charles IV and bears the crown with which he was crowned. From that time on, all pretenders to the German crown were received in front of the city gates with this reliquary and led to the church. Architecturally, a big choir and numerous chapel were added to the collegiate church in this time, first to accommodate the growing numbers of altars. Some of these chapels fulfilled additional functions for the coronation. In one of them, the king had to pray in the night before he was crowned. In another one, the electors had to reconfirm the election that had taken place in Frankfurt before. The large choir itself, however, was only used by the collegiate and had no function in the coronation ceremony. This took place only in the true remains of the Carolingian Palace Church. Interestingly still, the exterior and appearance of the choir was to remind of the royal chapel of the French king in Paris, the Saint-Chapelle. With their previous provisions, Louis and Charles IV divided the former palace into the possession of two competing institutions, the church and the city. Only the coronation ceremony as it was set in the Golden Bull in 1356 and the specification of the Aachen pilgrimage tied both parts together for the individual duration of the according function. On the other hand, the unifying Gothic design put the two former palace buildings into a new kind of ensemble that can be easily compared with the royal palace on the Ile de la Cité in Paris, which was newly built in the 13th and 14th century. This place surely was the new model for Aachen after all Charles IV grew up at the French court. However, most probably the French already adopted the bipolar structure of the Carolingian Palace of Aachen for their layout. Here the Sainte Chapelle, and directly opposite, with the same orientation, the Grand Salle. In this way, they again employed the Jerusalem concept and changed their position with a strong reference to Charlemagne. Thus, the Gothic design in Aachen can be understood as a re-import of the original building idea in a new architectural form. Thank you for your attention.